tonight on Dateline.
Who'd be happy to open the bidding?
Whilst many Australians are priced out of the housing market...
At $3,322,000... Stop.
Imagine a place where you can buy a home for just $1.50.
This one is the first house at 1 euro that I want to show you.
Oh, this is actually one euro.
Wow.
But what's the catch?
There's no bathroom here. I think they would have probably just washed
it. I think they're overrated bathrooms.
Yeah.
Are foreign buyers the answer to help reverse Italy's rural depopulation problem? Or could there be another solution?
E noi aiutavamo la gente che arrivava dal mare. Allo stesso modo, la gente che arriva a Camini aiuta il paese a rivivere.
In central Sicily, the hilltop town of Mussomeli is a maze of medieval streets and historic houses. And it's experiencing a property boom at the lower end of the market. Today, I'm meeting a local real estate agent who's going to show me what's on the market.
Buongiorno.
Hi, I'm Evan.
Valeria. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, thanks very much for seeing us today.
It was a pleasure.
So what are we going to see first?
This one is the first house at 1 euro that I want to show you.
1 euro?
Yeah, it's really? 1 euro, yeah.
Wow, let's have a look.
Yeah, let's go.
Has this just come on the market then?
Yeah, it's a new one.
I'm expecting a house at this price will need a lot of work.
All right, okay.
Here there is a kind of living room.
Right on top there is the tiles.
Yeah, exactly. We are on the top of the house.
But it's in good nick, it's quite nice.
Yeah.
Let's have a look at the other room.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, ensuite.
Yeah, with the bathroom.
Bathroom, yeah, there you go. That's obviously been put in, it's a modern addition.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
I'm surprised to find the house is livable.
This is quite nice. Let's have a look. This is the classic sort of Italian balcony or Sicilian balcony, right? Oh, look, and you can see the mountain there. That's great.
Yeah, you can see the mountain.
Yeah, nice place for a coffee.
Yeah.
So this is the old medieval section, and then that, are we seeing, is that all the new section?
Exactly.
Great. It's a really spectacular town though, isn't it? All up here in the mountains.
Foreigners are drawn to Italy's cobbled streets and rustic charm. It's no Florence or Venice, but here in Mussomeli, anyone can buy a slice of the Italian dream for less than a cup of coffee. And they're selling fast.
Now, what about some of these places? Are any of these coming on the market?
Well, this one. Oh. We sold this one. Here living, we sold that one.
Really? Are these all 1 euro houses?
No. No house more than 1 euro.
Okay.
But probably this one will be soon on the market at 1 euro.
This
we are
one
working
here.
On this, yes?
I quite like the look of it.
You want to buy it?
I like the balcony, yeah. I've got one on me now.
I can keep it for you.
Good, please. I like that one. Well, let's go and have a look.
Let's go.
I see. Oh, wow, okay. Nice high ceilings.
Yeah.
Okay, so tell me about this place.
Well, here, this is like the living room. Mm-hmm. There is a toilet there that probably I will advise to take it out.
Renovate. Okay.
But okay,
so interesting space, different to the other one.
Exactly.
Worse condition.
Yeah.
You can smell it's a bit musty, so it's a bit damp.
Right? Yeah,
Would you say water's getting in here somewhere?
Probably yes, because this one is like the original roof.
How much do you think people have to put into these houses to bring them back? I know it's different because it depends on the problem, depends on the materials.
Yeah.
But roughly speaking, how much would you say have to put into this?
A minimum of 20,000, 25,000 in the house at 1 euro you have to calculate. Like really a minimum. Then more, yes, less, no.
Yeah. And that would depend on the actual condition.
I mean,
if it didn't have a roof, for example.
Yeah.
Do you ever walk into a place and think, even for 1 euro, I'm not going to sell this?
Yeah, it's happened sometimes, but even though we sell it, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The reason these places are so cheap is because there are so many of them. In the past few decades alone, Over a million Italians left their towns and villages, moving to the cities or abroad in search of work and opportunities. Mussomeli is a textbook example. The town has houses for about 40,000 people, but a population of only 11,000. And the old homes have been abandoned for years.
So how many 1 euro homes are for sale now, and how many have you sold?
In this moment, available are around 30. That we sold around 100.
100 already?
Yeah.
Since 2017?
Yeah.
So it's been very successful?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
It is.
Just on the market?
Yeah, for sale.
This one? And this one?
Yeah, it's just one house.
Oh, that's one big house, is it?
Yeah.
That's quite big.
Yeah, it is. But need a lot of work.
Is it? Yeah.
How many square meters is that?
Around 100.
Taking on a huge renovation for a 1 euro house requires commitment, and not just a financial one. Buyers have to consider whether they really want to live here.
Hello, Danny.
Hi, Evan.
Hi, yes, it's Evan. Knock, knock.
Come in.
How are you?
Yeah, really good, thanks.
Nice
how
to
are you?
Meet you. Good. This is amazing. So what's an Australian doing in a town like this, in a house like this?
Good question, Evan. Good question. So I was looking to move to Italy. I've been obviously Australian in London for 23 years. Passionate about Italy, and I saw it as a way of moving here and a sort of an entry into life in Sicily.
And so what did you like about this one?
I don't have any building skills and I'm not a great handyman, but I could tell with this house that the foundations were pretty good, and that it was in a pretty good state compared to many of them, which are just rubble. What I loved about this place is it's original. It's been abandoned for 15 years. So when I walked in, it was just as if the person had got up and left. Actually, sadly, she died. So it's a bit of a mess. Come and have a look. Mind your way, there's no lights or anything. This was the bedroom. The lady actually died here. They had all the chairs lined up here, because that's what they do to view her and say goodbye. The TV was covered in the corner, but it still didn't freak me out. I've saved a lot of her stuff just because there's some good memories here and some lovely objects. But it is almost like the kids come and take what they want, the family, and then the rest is just left. So this is the kitchen.
Okay, wow, another big
and
room.
And I think this is what, Evan, this has sold the house for me. I don't know, I can just imagine people sitting around the table, eating, wood-fired stove there.
Oh, wow.
I mean, you know, they've done the 70s renovations or whatever and added things, but
yeah. A
lot of it's kind of original. Okay, and this is the balcony.
Lovely.
Yep.
So, Danny, I know you're a tough guy, but it doesn't look like you live in here.
No, I don't live here, Evan. It's going to take a while for it to be renovated. So rather than renting another place, I decided to look around for somewhere to buy, and I found a place for 8,000 euros, so I bought that. That's where I live.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So that's still not bad price.
It's amazing.
For a house.
For a house.
8,000
euros.
Yeah. Yep. Compared to London prices or even, you know, Australian prices.
Absolutely.
These days, right?
Absolutely.
Exactly.
The median Australian house price is now close to $1 million. But Danny's about to show me the house he lives in. And it costs just $12,500.
And this is mine. This is my abode.
A McCubbin. There
it is. A McCubbin. Yeah, you can't miss it. Okay, so here we are. This is my living room.
Oh, okay. Oh, gorgeous.
Yeah.
This is much better, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, very nice, livable.
Thank you. My living
complete.
Room. Yep. With a balcony and a view as well.
Gorgeous, right down the valley. So, the people you meet, the locals in this area, how do they feel about Danny McCubbin coming from Australia, moving into this house your house for 1 euro? What's the reaction?
To be honest, Evan, they were a bit dubious at first. Really, they were just
a dubious character.
Yeah. I mean, you know, so suspicious. I think they are welcoming. They're welcoming though if you have the right attitude.
With young people leaving town for education and jobs, it's mainly the older generation that remain. One neighbour Danny has made friends with is 91-year-old Salvatore, who lives alone.
Ciao, Salvatore. Come stai?
Sinestura mi siento.
Forte, tu sì. Forte. Io, marmellata.
Che?
Melone, con sogno, melone. salsa.
Che? Salsa.
Salsa.
C'è un decapitato, che no cosa?
No.
Se tu grappi due, ti faccio vedere che cosa c'hai io. Di tutto.
Tutto?
Tutto, non so cosa andò.
Ok, non posso salsa? No.
No, portatile.
Ok, ok.
Fa un'altra persona
okay.
Che ha bisogno di me.
Salvatore has seen a lot of changes in this town and he's worried about it one day being empty.
Nesta strada. Se ci dico quando... Quando casa è chiusa ci sono 12 case vacante, quando non ci stanno sono, che hanno murato e si chiude la porta. Oggi domani che questa casa si chiude a vedere, perché le mie figlie l'hanno tolta le case e si chiude.
Ciao. Salvatore and I have become good friends. I love his company. Some days I just sit there and talk, and I just think to myself, if somebody who's 91, who's probably never left Sicily, can be so open-minded to accept me and to accept people buying these 1 euro houses, then that's a good thing. That's a good thing for the town.
Many towns in Italy have 1 euro home schemes. But Mussomeli has been hailed a success thanks to clever marketing. Instead of enticing young Italians here to repopulate, they're targeting foreigners and the dream of owning an Italian home. The city gets around 1,000 emails a day asking about 1 euro homes. And on almost any given day, you'll find people like Tia and her friends walking the streets looking for one.
I just bought a 1 euro house now.
You just bought one?
Yeah.
Really? Already? Today?
Really now. Today, yes.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Hello, hello. Good
hi,
morning.
Hi.
Wow, where did you buy the house? Just today?
Yes, today, not far away from here.
Oh, fantastic. How long have you been looking?
For 23 hours.
So, what is it you like about the one you've bought?
First of all, I had a vision. When I first heard about the project of 1 euro houses, I had a vision with a small town, a lot of stones, a very old town, and me getting to my house, to my 1 euro house, getting inside to a small path and taking a house, taking something which is nothing today, and making the most beautiful house in that place.
Tia is Israeli but lives in Romania. She plans to turn her new purchase into a spiritual retreat.
And what sort of state of repair is it in? How much work do you think you need to do on it?
Well, it's a lot. It's a lot, because I wasn't even allowed to get inside.
Oh.
It's so dangerous.
Okay, so do you know roughly how much it might cost to renovate?
No, but I don't care.
Only a few foreign buyers make the decision to move here permanently. Someone who's gone all in with Mussomeli is Danny.
Grazie, Frank. Come stai? Ciao, Marshall.
Not only has he bought two houses, he also rents a space for an ambitious project.
Hi, Danny. How are you?
Great, thanks.
Well,
how are
nice
you?
It's nice and warm in here.
Yeah, it's a bit chilly out there.
It is today, isn't it? Yeah. So what's this place?
This is the Good Kitchen. So we rescue the food from the supermarkets. They deliver it to us. And then we make good, nutritious meals for vulnerable people of the town.
Danny has a background in food. In London, he worked for celebrity chef Jamie Oliver on social food programs. Now, he's setting up a community kitchen in an old shopfront on the town piazza.
My primary goal with the Good Kitchen is that it becomes a social enterprise. So then we actually start employing the young people of the town. 50% unemployment for youth in Sicily. So my primary objective is that it becomes a business, and that it's functioning business, and then we employ the young people to run it.
Oh, I see. So it's actually, and which is one of the key reasons why people are leaving, right?
Yes.
Or have been leaving in
absolutely.
The past, right?
Absolutely.
Helping Danny today are a group of young friends like Salvatore, who's here on a court-ordered community service.
Diciamo che è un modo per aiutare la comunità, far stare bene con me stesso, quindi sì. Poi mi ci trovo bene, è un ambiente fantastico, Danny è una persona meravigliosa, quindi mi ci trovo bene.
The group's youngest member, 10-year-old Davide, is also inspired.
Da grande mi vorrò aprire un ristorante con degli amici.
But this for you is more, it's more than just buying a cheap house.
Absolutely. I mean, the 1 euro house was the hook, but that it's a lifestyle for me.
And he has advice for others thinking of buying a 1 euro home.
I'm quite adamant when somebody reaches out to me and says, look, I'm thinking of coming to setting up a B&B, or somebody wants to set up a business, a restaurant or a cafe. I say to them, please don't. If you set up a business and take it away from the people of the town, then that's not a good thing in a town that's struggling anyway. Mm. So if you work remotely, fantastic. It's a great opportunity for you. But also I say, think of something that's going to give jobs to the people of the town. That's the most important thing.
Grazie mille a tutti. Buon appetito. Come on, start.
With a boom in remote working, small towns like this are starting to see a trickle of new residents looking for a slower and cheaper way of life. But there are an estimated 2,500 villages across Italy on their way to becoming ghost towns. So it would take thousands of people like Danny moving permanently to reverse the depopulation trend. I'm on my way to Calabria, one of Italy's poorest regions, to visit a town getting a new lease on life, thanks to foreigners who are desperate to call Italy home. Camini is home to only 300 locals and over 100 refugees. Rosario and Giusy are the driving forces behind an idea that saved the town from abandonment. They run a cooperative that helps integrate refugees into Italian society.
Can you come in the afternoon to talk with her?
Their state-funded program provides refugees with language classes, job training and community activities.
Okay.
Giusy and Rosario are the brains behind the scheme.
Sì. Sono nato a Camini, ho frequentato le scuole, però avevo sempre la speranza di non essere come uno dei tanti giovani calabresi obbligati ad andare via. In quel momento, quando noi eravamo ragazzi, quando avevo 18 anni, il paese non era più vivibile. Tantissime, pure ora dove ci troviamo a fare questa intervista, questa strada era chiusa perché era pericolante. Era pericolante perché tutte le abitazioni stavano cadendo. Non erano delle case che gli abitanti caminesi avevano abbandonate, avevano lasciato vuote. E allora là nasce l'idea della cooperativa, ma in quel momento non nasce un'idea dell'accoglienza. L'idea dell'accoglienza arriva dopo, nel 2011.
Before they could bring migrants to Camini to revitalize the town, they had to make the town livable. With government funding, they've renovated enough houses for 118 people.
So this is a really good spot to see what Camini was like before the program started. This is part of the old part of the town. It was falling apart, needs repair. Obviously, it's in a real state. Whereas just next to it is a place that's been renovated and repaired. They're now using it for tourist accommodation. Looks really cute, but it's more than that, actually. They're preserving here hundreds of years of culture and tradition and life.
But to bring the town back to life, they needed help. So in 2011, Giusy and Rosario organised for a small group of migrants to kickstart their program.
Era la nostra prima esperienza ed eravamo un po', a dire il vero, preoccupati di questo, anche perché si trattava di accogliere 11 ragazzi di sesso maschile provenienti dall'Africa ed era il primo impatto con l'accoglienza della comunità di Camini.
Despite the initial reservations, the initiative was a success. And it was soon to take off in a big way. Since the European migrant crisis in 2015, over 750,000 asylum seekers and migrants crossed the Mediterranean and landed in Italy. It was a pivotal moment for Comini.
In quel momento la comunità aveva capito che era fondamentale fare accoglienza, perché Comini era in un punto di non ritorno, perché Comini stava scomparendo. Che noi aiutavamo la gente che arrivava dal mare, ma allo stesso modo la gente che arriva a Comini aiuta il paese a rivivere.
Two people enjoying a second chance at life are father and daughter Mohammed and Dua.
Hi, ciao.
Buonasera.
They're refugees from Syria.
In 2012, إيه سقط مبنى علي على علي أثر يعني الحرب والقذائف. وصار في عندي خلل بالعمود الفقري. وجينا لهون على إيطاليا. يعني مشكورين كفوا العلاج.
Per me Comini è un posto molto importante perché mi ha cambiato la mia vita qui. Sono riuscita a essere forte, trovare un lavoro, studiare. Le cose più importanti nella mia vita l'ho trovata qui. Voglio tanto rimanere qui e cercare di aiutare la cooperativa, di migliorare, di andare avanti.
While many of the new arrivals that come through Comini move on, it seems the town is also becoming a home for others. But in a village just a few kilometres away, the local mayor became famous for welcoming migrants, and as a result, is facing jail. Rural Italy has long suffered from depopulation, leaving picturesque towns feeling abandoned. That is, until a place tries to do something about it. Just like the village of Comini, there's another town nearby that was once world famous for giving a warm welcome to migrants. And I reported from there back in 2015. Domenico Lucano is Riace's mayor. Having grown up in the crumbling town, today he's determined to reverse its sleepy image with a plan that could also solve one of Italy's biggest problems.
Un processo graduale, un'immigrazione è un fenomeno del tutto imprevisto.
Rather than shun migrants like the rest of the country, he wants to welcome them. Today, signs welcome refugees in languages from Arabic to French, as those accepted as genuine refugees move into the homes others have left behind. Trained in jobs and given a modest stipend, immigrants now make up around a quarter of the population. Back then, Riace's scheme and the man behind it were hailed a huge success. In 2016, the mayor was even named in Fortune's iconic annual list of the world's 50 greatest leaders, alongside Angela Merkel, Pope Francis, and Justin Trudeau. But no one could have predicted what would happen next. The massive inflow of asylum seekers, refugees, and migrants to Italy was followed by a rise in anti-migrant politics. Riding this to power, the right-wing League Party and its leader Matteo Salvini targeted Riace and its mayor. Then a surprise twist. In 2018, the mayor was charged with abetting illegal immigration, fraud, forgery, and embezzlement. Charges, he said, were political.
Oh,
The case made international headlines and triggered protests against the central government. Prosecutors asked for 7 years in jail. He was given 13. However, he's still living in Riace whilst he awaits the outcome of his appeals.
This place certainly feels very different to 2015. I'm seeing virtually no people around, and I'm certainly not seeing anywhere near the same number of refugees or migrants here. The reason I've come back to Riace is to try and meet the mayor. Yeah, hello.
Feeling the stress of the prosecution, initially he didn't want to talk.
No.
But he eventually warmed up.
Ho reagito istintivamente perché istintivamente rispetto alla macchina da presa, rispetto a quello che per me è diventato per alcuni aspetti anche un incubo mediatico.
What's been the impact of the case on your migrant program in Riace?
Oggi Riace è ritornato ad essere uno dei tanti paesi agonizzanti di questo profondo sud dove non rimane nulla, le persone se ne vanno, non si può vivere in contesti dove la vita sociale si riduce praticamente a zero.
But what in your view are the forces behind this?
Il tentativo di delegittimare Riace è avvenuto a livelli più alti, ai livelli in cui lo Stato, quell'area grigia, quella borghesia mafiosa riesce a condizionare, è il pensiero che ha disturbato la destra, il pensiero che in un piccolo luogo abbandonato è stato possibile. E allora vogliono, non sono tanto io sono lo strumento per ma delegittimare l'idea. E un giorno ho la speranza di una giustizia vera.
Riace once had 800 refugees and migrants from more than 20 different countries living here, creating businesses, filling up schools, and bringing life to the town. A political shift and alleged mismanagement have left it sadly empty once again. But its moment in the spotlight inspired other towns to welcome foreigners.
Proprio quello che mi appartiene, quello che mi piace fare, lavorare nel sociale e unire a un'impresa umanitaria anche la rinascita e la rivalutazione del mio territorio, quello che amo e nel quale sono voluta rimanere, ho scelto di rimanere.
Ciao, buongiorno.
Ciao.
Ma la cosa importante è che il paese ormai è vivo, un paese che tante persone sono interessate a venirci.
Buongiorno.